My spidey senses are tingling.
Hey, Lorenzo, we're cleaning here. Come and help.
My spidey senses are tingling, and they are saying that Copycat Friday is going to be awesome. Hey guys, I'm Janik from Cinecom.net, and welcome back to Copycat Friday. Like you saw, we are going to recreate Spider-Man today, and you can even say it's going to be a amazing Spider-Man tutorial. Get it? All jokes aside, let's get into it. Apparently I scare Jill too much. As you can see, he's used to it now, but now I can't train to be a supervillain anymore. That's too bad, I really want to be a supervillain. What should be my supervillain name? Let me know in the comments. Anyways, it's time for the effect and we are going to recreate the Spider-Man swing. And for this you are going to need two shots. The first shot is going to be a tripod shot of the environment, so the place where you are going to swing. For the second shot we are going to need three things: a tripod, a green screen and a rope. Attach the rope to something high and sturdy, place the green screen behind the rope and film from your tripod. And oh yeah, don't forget to match the light from outside. Light is of course very important. Then your actor can hang from the rope and let him pretend to swing. Because we are swinging around the corner, the perspective of Lorenzo will change. First we will see his front, then his side and last his back. To recreate this, just let your actor spin around in front of the green screen. It's that simple. Now for the post-production and After Effects. The first thing we are going to do is place the environment shot in your empty composition. Take your actor clip and place it on top. Now because we didn't time our actor spinning around, we are going to time remap this to our likings. So right click on the actor clip, go to time and choose enable time remapping. Create a keyframe in the beginning and then look for the point your actor starts turning to his side. Here create a new keyframe, now drag this close to the first one to speed it up. You can place it around the 15 frames mark. Now look for the point your actor again turns around showing his back. Create a keyframe and drag the keyframe to the 30 frame mark. Now do this one more time for the ending. Look for the point where he's completely turned around and drag that keyframe to the 1 second 15 frames mark. This will leave you with your actor spinning around in 1.5 seconds. If you want, you can always shorten your composition to that 1.5 second. Just press Ctrl K and this will open up the composition settings where you can shorten your comp. Next up is pre-comping the actor clip and moving all attributes into a new composition. On this new composition, we are going to create a mask so that we only have our actor with the green screen. With the key light effect, we are going to remove the green, and now it's time for the next step, the swinging. First, set the anchor point on the hands of the actor. Second, make the actor layer 3D. Now let's position the actor on the start frame. With the position, you can place the actor on the right side of your shot. Then decrease the scale of the actor. Last, also rotate the actor on his left side with the orientation. Now enable the animation for the position, scale and orientation. Then go to the middle of the clip. Here you can increase the scale, set the position to the middle of the clip. And we are also going to use the Z axis to move the clip forward in the 3D space. You can enable the two view mode to do this more precisely. Last, set the orientation back to normal. For the ending of the clip, we are again going to decrease the scale, position him to the left and again backwards, also rotate him on his right side, and this will leave you with the swinging movement. Of course, if you want, you can also adjust the movement between the keyframes we already made, making the movement even better and to your likings. A good tip is that your hands are always pointing towards the building. And of course, also enable the motion blur. Now the last thing will be our rope, and this is quite simple. Just import our free spiderweb asset and place it on top of everything. Then take the puppet pin tool. Create 4 puppet pins, 3 on the web that is attached to the building and 1 on the end of the rope. Now open up the properties for the puppet pin tool effect and then open up the mesh option. First you can increase the expansion a lot. Next open up the deform option and look for the puppet pin that lays on the end of the rope. Again open this up and enable the animation for the puppet position. Now just like before, we are going to animate it to follow the actor. If your web string is acting funny, just increase the expansion until you have something you like. Now last, enable the motion blur for the string layer. And if you want, you can also increase the motion blur by pressing Ctrl K, going to the advanced tab, and then you just increase the shutter angle and you're good to go.
My spidey senses are tingling.
Hey, Lorenzo! We're cleaning here! Come and help!
Okay, in our sketch we also did two other effects. I'm also going to explain them, but super fast. However, I first want to thank our sponsor, Storyblocks Video. This is a stock library, but also a filmmaker's best friend. In their expanding library, you can find everything. From aerial shots, to nature shots, to underwater shots, and even scary themed shots. They have everything. And I'm 100% certain that you will find something you need on there. Because who doesn't want super easy to customize After Effects templates? And the best thing about Storyblocks Video is that you only have to pay one single price per year for unlimited downloads. So don't wait another minute and go to the first link in the description below. Now for the other two effects, and I'm going to go super fast, because we already made two other Spider-Man tutorials where we explain web shooting and wall crawling. Link in the description below, of course. First up is web shooting. Animate your web swing asset so that it comes out of your hand. You can add a turbulent displace effect to make it more natural. Then add some smoke when you shoot, and that's it. However, we did something extra this time. We also pulled on the string. Super easy. First, track your hand, and this needs to be on the point where your string comes out of your hand. Apply the tracking data to a null object, and next create a puppet pin on the end of the web string. Then parent the puppet pin position with the position of the null object, and last create three more puppet pins on the web where it's stuck on the building. And that's it. For the last effect, the wall crawling, just film a wall. Then the second shot is going to be a green screen shot. Place the green screen on the floor and also upright. Then let your actor stand on his hands and feet on the green screen, like a spider. Then to fake the landing, let your actor jump up and land on the green screen. Then composite the two shots together and again, that's it. Now it's time for Janik's Fun Fact Function! Well, Lorenzo is in luck. Apparently Spider-Man's web dissolves in 1 hour. And yet, it's strong enough to hold the Hulk and even faster than a bullet. That's insane. But also good to know. Probably. And that was it for today, guys. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you, Storyblocks Video, for the support. And like always, stay creative. Of course, you can also adjust the movement between the keyframes we already made.